We'll take a closer look at the recent tragedy in Vegas and hear from a local San Diego reporter who happened to be near where the tragic shooting took place.
Plus, the DACA deadline expired, leaving many with a sense of uncertainty. We will tell you what's being done to help those affected.
And a rock legend passes away this week, and millions around the world are devastated.
And another hurricane is likely to make the U.S. landfall by early Sunday morning. Colton Chavez will have more on the hurricane, Nate. Plus, our local weather forecast news scene starts now.
Good evening, and I'm Christian Gomez.
And I'm Claudia Robles.
We start tonight by heartbreaking news in Las Vegas. Here's Marissa with more.
Las Vegas is healing after a country music festival turned deadly last Sunday. At least a dozen people from San Diego were caught in the crossfire. We spoke with a local reporter who happens to be a former City College student from New Scene after her harrowing experience.
The shooter, identified as Stephen Paddock, targeted thousands of innocent people attending a country music concert near the Las Vegas Strip Sunday night.
You guys, get down! Go that way! Get out of here! There's gunshots coming from over there! Go
Paddock, using semi-automatic rifles, gunned down 59 people, injuring hundreds of others from 32 floors up in the Mandalay Bay Hotel. KFMB reporter Shannon Handy just happened to be less than a mile away when it happened.
I was scared. I was shaking. When we finally made it back to our hotel, we could not get in because the hotels on the Strip were on lockdown.
She was on a getaway weekend with her husband, but ended up staying to work after the story broke. Many of the victims have now been identified, including Jennifer Irvine, a San Diego attorney, among them. Survivors are sharing the unforgettable moments as they ran for their lives.
And we actually pretty much told each other goodbye.
He covered me all the way, So he was going to take my bullets.
As victims grieve over the loss of their loved ones, Shannon Handy says despite the sadness, she felt a sense of unity and there remains hope that Las Vegas will eventually recover.
People from Las Vegas would come and deliver water and snacks and handwritten notes to not only the media but the first responders. And they basically wanted to say thank you and they wanted to get their message out, which was Vegas strong.
The shooter's girlfriend, Mary Lou Danley, was away in the Philippines and after questioning, claims she suspected nothing. Eric Paddock Stevens' brother is adamant that the family was dumbfounded by the massacre. The president and first lady also traveled to Vegas to meet with victims on Wednesday. As more comes out through investigation, we'll keep you updated right here on New Scene. That's all I have for breaking news today. Back to you two at the desk.
Thanks for that update, Marissa. Now, following the horror of the mass shooting in Vegas on Sunday night, authorities are investigating the life and mental state of the shooter, Stephen Paddock. The 64-year-old wealthy retiree was a real estate agent and property owner and had no criminal record. His brother, Eric Paddock, describes him as a multimillionaire, high-stakes gambler. Eric Paddock tells media sources that his brother moved to Nevada in 2012 to play high-level poker. According to the Chicago Tribune, Stephen Paddock also booked a reservation for a hotel room overlooking the Lollapalooza Festival in Chicago in August, but did not show up. Officials are wondering whether Paddock planned to attack other outdoor festivals. Paddock had been collecting firearms since 1982 and that he had been purchasing 33 firearms last year. Multiple people from Paddock's life, including his brother, former neighbor, and girlfriend, have come forward describing Paddock as a kind, normal guy.
President Donald Trump visited Las Vegas on Wednesday, days after the deadliest mass shooting. The president and the first lady, Melania Trump, went to the University Medical Center's Trauma Center to meet and consult with some of the victims. They also met with police first responders and congratulated them on a job well done. Trump held a conference calling a shooting an act of pure evil.
In the depths of horror, we will always find hope in the men and women who risk their lives for ours. The mass murder that took place on Sunday night fills America's heart with grief. America is truly a nation in mourning.
This photo of Air Force One departing Vegas flying past the broken windows of the Mandalay Bay resort has gone viral.
San Diego is home to some of the victims and heroes of this week's Vegas shooting. Two San Diego police officers were off duty at the concert. Max Berdosco and Tom McGrath gave a statement on Wednesday.
We took cover behind several vehicles, and at that point I was just telling people what I've been trained to know, you know, hide behind the engines, the wheel wells, and places that are gonna actually provide cover and not just the concealment.
Also from San Diego Valley Center resident Jeffrey Kosher was shot twice in the leg and hip. He says strangers applied a tourniquet and loaded him into an SUV so he could be immediately transported to the hospital. Friends of Jeffrey's created a GoFundMe page to raise money for his medical bills. Over $20,000 was raised in the first 2 days.
There was an emotional gathering at the church in North Park on Wednesday. Representatives of the church say they want everyone to feel welcome and mourn all the victims of the Las Vegas mass shooting.
And so our action tonight is to bring together people of all faiths so that we can come up with a plan to do something so that all of this tragedy can end.
It was somber, yet the mood was uplifting. This was a celebration of the life for the victims that have survived.
And while the loss of 59 people after the deadliest mass shooting in the United States history, the American public is once again torn over the debate of gun control. On Tuesday, the House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders stated that there is a time and place for political debate, but now is the time to unite as a country. Multiple media outlets, including late-night TV hosts, state the opposite. They claim that because there have been 273 mass shootings in the U.S. in 2017 alone, this is a time to discuss regulating firearms. The Las Vegas shooter, Stephen Paddock, purchased 33 firearms in 2016 and apparently used a device called buntstock to alter his rifles to shoot more rounds. These devices fit over the stock of semi-automatic rifle and enable the weapon to fire continuously. The National Rifle Association joined the White House on Thursday in stating that regulations must be made on buntstocks.
The deadline for the DACA program expires last night. We will update you on what it means for recipients.
And a football superstar has lost an endorsement deal for something he said. Find out who in sports.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
I did. Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls.
But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know that strollers have the right of way on the sidewalk?
Yes.
Yep, I did. Did you guys
did
know?
Did you know that kids who eat breakfast have higher GPAs?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah. That's actually what I was going to say.
Did you know babies should never touch silver? It's really bad for them.
I knew that.
Did you guys know that statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
I'm putting that on my blog.
I just put it in mine.
The countdown is over for thousands of Dreamers. Yesterday was a deadline for them to reapply for their temporary visas. As Celia Jimenez tells us, many fear what comes next.
I am terrified.
Yesterday was the last day to apply for the Deferred Act of Childhood Arrivals known as DACA. President Donald Trump discontinued the program on September 5th on the grounds that Obama's executive order was a unilateral decision. Within days, thousands of recipients rushed to fill out the paperwork and pay the application fee of almost $500 to renew their two-year permit. Without a plan B, Trump sent DACA to Congress and gave them a six-month deadline to come with a solution.
Today marks the deadline.
On Thursday, many protested on DACA in different cities around the country. During a rally in D.C., Democratic Senator Elizabeth Warren said,
America made a promise to our dreamers, and it is up to us now in the United States Congress to do the will of the American people.
Congress has been unable to pass any type of immigration reform in over a decade. Democrats appealed to the Department of Homeland Security, asking for the deadline to extend one more month. According to the data from U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services, nearly 30%, or more than 42,000 eligible individuals, did not submit the renewal application. Permits will start expiring next year, and Dreamers are preparing for the worst.
I would have to go back to like doing odd jobs that pay you under the table, collecting cans. I mean, this is how it was before 2012. I mean, but it's just have to survive until maybe someone else comes along and gives us the opportunity to work and study again.
The split Congress will have to come up with an immigration plan by March. If not, thousands will lose their jobs and face deportation.
The Trump administration is considering rolling back a requirement that most employers provide free contraception in their medical plans. This rule went into effect during the Obama administration in 2012. The Center for Reproductive Rights plans to fight this change, saying that contraceptive benefits enable women to pursue their educational and professional goals.
A man is in custody after terrorizing a family daycare in Chula Vista. Gustavo Supalavida is now facing 11 counts of attempted murder after breaking into an ex-girlfriend's home while seven children were under the facility's care. Before breaking into the daycare, the shooter set several fires, including a car nearby. The Chula Vista Police Department arrived on the scene with firefighters to investigate the fire crimes. As shots were being fired, the children were locked inside a bathroom, and the ex-girlfriend fired her own guns as self-defense to keep the shooter away. And thankfully, the children and the employees were safely evacuated.
City officials announced Wednesday the opening of a new campground in Golden Hill, intended to serve numerous homeless who have been swept up in the effort to battle San Diego's hepatitis A outbreak. The site will have a 24-hour security, restrooms, showers, and storage. The facility city vehicle lot, located at 20th and B Streets, will house 200 people. Priority will be giving out to seniors, the disabled, and mothers of children. Pets will be allowed. The camp will serve as temporary transitional housing until the city can get the 3% recently proposed industrial tent shelters up and running in December.
The San Diego police officers are training for interactions with people suffering a mental crisis. PERT is a mobile psychiatric emergency response team that train law enforcement officers to communicate with subjects who may display unstable, aggressive, or threatening behavior. PERT's clinicians also team up with police in the field to assess, de-escalate, or redirect subjects to the mental health services instead of hospitalization or jail. Numerous recent rounds of shooting involved people with mental crises have underscored the need for specialized training. Police calls of a psychiatric nature have increased 92% in the San Diego County since 2009.
Desperation continues to grow in Puerto Rico following the disaster of Hurricane Maria. President Donald Trump visited Puerto Rico earlier this week only to find a disloyal community in the need of a helping hand.
Since we're not bad people,
we help when there's disasters. Why aren't we getting the help
now?
He says, the president says that nothing happened here, but what more do you want to happen to me, he says.
He needs water, he says, for his house. Some food, he says he doesn't have any food either. No tienes nada. No. He says everything is gone, he says. His home is gone. He says his home is made of wood and it's all gone.
Local citizens hope the visit will bring attention to their need for aid, but many are still doubtful.
Earlier this week, O.J. Simpson was released from prison. After serving 9 years in prison, Simpson was convicted of kidnapping and armed robbery at a Las Vegas hotel. He was granted parole back in July and will start his post-prison life by staying in Vegas. The new parole plans on moving to Florida in the near future.
And here is Billy King with what's going on in the world of sports. Billy?
Well, thank you so much, guys. And it's well known that kryptonite is Superman's weakness. Well, earlier this week, turns out it's really sexism, as quarterback Cam Newton, also known as Superman, is in hot water after the sexist remarks he made earlier this week towards a female NFL beat writer. Charlotte Observer reporter Jordan Rodrigue asked a question to Cam Newton, in which he replied, "It's funny to hear a female talk about routes," which didn't sit well with the reporter. To add insult to injury, the yogurt company Danone, which is one of Newton's many sponsors, has cut ties with him in the aftermath of the comments. Saying the NFL, the Tampa Bay Bucks hosted the New England Patriots for Thursday night football, and it came down to the wire. Down by 5, the Bucks needed a touchdown to win the game, but with 3 seconds left in the game on the 20-yard line, Bucks quarterback Jameis Winston's pass fell short of the end zone, and the Pats win with a score of 19-14. But here's the kicker. Bucks kicker Nick Folk missed 3 field goal attempts in the game, which would have put his team ahead with the lead and possible victory. But as Porky the Pig says, it's always a buddy, that's all, folks. And with the win, quarterback Tom Brady he ties the record for the most winningest quarterback with Brett Favre and Peyton Manning. And on to college football, the San Diego State Aztec came away with a victory against Northern Illinois 34-28. After being poked in the eye, Aztec's running back Rashad Penny went out of the game but returned with the fury to gain 200 all-purpose yards and a 33-yard touchdown reception from Aztec quarterback Christian Chapman. Some say it was a poke that stroked the fire. The Aztecs are off to their best start since the 1975 season, where they started 8-0. The Aztecs go on the road this week against their arch rivals, UNLV Rebels. And finally, onto the diamond, the first round of the Major League Baseball playoffs took place deep in the heart of Texas. The Houston Astros host the Boston Red Sox in a best-of-5 series. American League Cy Young favorite and Boston Red Sox starting pitcher Chris Sale was roughed up and allowed 7 runs in 5 innings in his postseason debut. But it was liftoff and all systems go for Astros batting champ Jose Altuve, as the second baseman hit 3 home runs in the game that helped guide the Astros to an 8-2 victory in the first game of the series. And that'll do all for sports. Back to you folks at the desk.
Thank you for that, Billy. And 6 American scientists were awarded a Nobel Prize this week for their work solving the mysteries of the human body and of the cosmos. That's the story after the break.
An Oscar-winning actor will play Hugh Hefner in the biopic. Learn who it is after the break.
They said I couldn't dream. Called me a piece of trash and swore that's all I'd ever be. Said a bottle couldn't see the ocean. Give up. Go back to the dumpster. But I didn't listen. I made my way. And now, I am what I've always wanted to be.
The social network Yahoo has announced that a total of 3 billion accounts have been affected by a hack that has happened in August 2013. Accounts also include email, Tumblr, Fantasy, and Flickr. That's 3 times as many as the company initially reported back in 2016. Yahoo is sending emails to all of its users to change their passwords and security questions. No financial information was breached at the time, according to Yahoo.
For students who couldn't register for fall classes back in August, they have an opportunity to sign up for short-term courses. More than 130 late start classes will soon be offered. There will be an 8-week session and six-week session. Some of the classes will be oral communication, critical thinking, and world history. For classes, go to reggie.com.
And calling all stressed-out students, it's time to put down the books and pick up a yoga mat. Every Wednesday from 12:30 to 1:30 in room BT303, the Mental Health Counseling Center will be offering a meditation group that includes gentle yoga. The goal is to help students cultivate awareness, manage stress, and increase emotional well-being. No prior experience is required, and students are invited to attend all sessions.
City College's Seats at City Farm Stand is a student organized market that happens every Tuesday from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. The market is located at 16th and currency and membership for reoccurring bags are $25 a week, which do include 8 to 12 different produce items. All proceeds go to the agriculture program here at City College. The Nobel Prize Committee has awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology for Medicine and the Nobel Prize in Physics to American scientists. Three American scientists share $1.1 million prize for their research into the human and animal biological clocks. Another three scientists, also American, won the Physics Award for detecting gravity waves, a phenomenon predicted by Einstein over a century ago.
And now, what's going on in entertainment? Devon, what's up?
Thank you. Tom Petty, a singer, songwriter, a guitarist, died on Monday. He was 66 years old. Petty's manager, Tony Dimitriad, says Petty suffered from a cardiac arrest in his home in Malibu, and he was taken to the UCLA Medical Center. He was pronounced dead at 8:40 p.m. with his family members, friends, bandmates present at the hospital. His songs were stapled of rock radio for decades, and the hits of Reggie, Don't Come Around Here No More, Free Fallin', Into the Open Wide, Petty sold millions of albums, headlines arenas, festivals around the world. The past Monday, PlayStation's president, global CEO Andrew House stepped down from his role. Position president of Sony Interactive Entertainment, John Carreiro, will take his place. House will remain the SIE and the chairman of the year transition for purposes, and the stick of Sony director and chairman of SIE. The House took PlayStation's reins of global president, and in 2011, he has been with the company since 1990, where he served corporate communications at Sony's headquarters. Last year, he led the merging of Sony's computer entertainment, Sony's network entertainment, to create the Sony Interactive Entertainment. Oscar-winning award Jared Leto will play the role of Playboy founder Hugh Hefner in the biopic Rush Hour director Bugh Ravner. The percentage passing, Hugh Hefner had many people viewing him as progressive figures and others viewing him as a distractor who common modified women. The hiring of Leto will play the role of Playboy, with a certain people taking about Ravner's Hugh Hefner biopic. Judy Greer is joining the Halloween franchise, as Karen Strode will play the daughter of father Jamie Lee character Lauren Strode. And no other details about how Karen will play use in the story have been released, although the casting could signal focus on Strode's family members. Greer is just being the new, it's the first to be in the new casting sequel. How many of the rest of the sequel will shape up? That's an eye to keep. Something to keep your eye on. Halloween sequel is set to air October 19, 2018. Getting ready for a collective of egos in the new network's Stranger Things mobile app, fashion as 80s era arcade style. Netflix will launch their game to play free promos to promote their season 2 of Supernatural Thriller season. Users must solve puzzles and take advantage of the unique abilities of characters. For instance, Luke is able to nail with his rocket, and Nancy is able to swing bats with her collection. That's all the time we have. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks for that, Devon. Now, with Hurricane Nate underway, Colin Chavez will have the latest news after the break. Okay, I didn't know.
It's a short ride from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
And for more on weather, here's Colton Chavez.
Thanks, Claudia. Tropical storm Nate dumped over Central America Thursday, killing 22 people. Fall storms like Nate have a tendency to pop up very quickly, making it hard for meteorologists to track. Nate is forecast to make landfall in the U.S. early Sunday, somewhere between southeast Louisiana and the Florida Panhandle. As of today, an official state of emergency has been declared for the state of Louisiana. Governor John Bell said everyone in South Louisiana should be preparing for this storm now. While we can't call looking at the bright side, the storm will be missing many areas that have been hit hardest by the hurricanes Irma and Harvey. All right, now let's go ahead and take a look at our regional forecast. So for our regional forecast, it's going to be in the mid-70s, about 75 degrees here in San Diego. Thank you. 74 in Carlsbad and 73 in Del Mar. As you can see, in the inland in Escondido, it's going to be 81 degrees and 79 in Poway. Now transitioning into our National Weather Service, we can see that it's going to be 75 to 80s in New York in the Northeast. And it's going to be down south in Washington, about 80 degrees, and 88 in Miami. Now, as we climb over to the west coast, up there in Portland, it's going to be 54, 65 down in San Francisco, and climb a little bit up to 74 in Los Angeles. Now, let's go ahead and look at your weekend forecast. Today, you're going to have a high of 81 degrees with a low of 61. Saturday, we're going to warm up to 88 with a low of 63. And on Sunday, 75 degrees with a low of 63, partially cloudy. And that's going to go ahead and warm up as the week goes on. And that's going to do it for us here in weather. Back to you guys at the desk.
This month marks the 7th annual Kids Free in October program, which is organized by the San Diego Museum Council and Scholar Share. More than 40 museums in the San Diego Museum Council will offer free admission to children 12 and under till the end of the month to provide the museum with the experience for all families. The free admission deal is only valid for up to 2 kids for every adult ticket purchased.
Well, thank you for that story, Christian. That's all for this. So with so many October festivities around San Diego, Christian, tell us, what are your plans?
Not much, to be honest, since we're still in midterms, I'm still hitting the books. I might go to a concert this weekend.
Nice.
At the North Park Observatory. That should be fun. And then maybe next week I'll think about maybe I'll go to the Halloween Horror attractions and Universal Studios. What about yourself?
Well, I'm thinking about checking out the Haunted Trails of Balboa Park.
Oh, yeah, that's a trip.
Have you ever been?
No, but every Friday I run around Balboa and I always see all the funky attractions when it's built up around this time. So that's, it's crazy to be honest.
That's great. Thank you so much, Christian. That's all for this week's episode. Tune in next week for San Diego National and International News.
I'm Christian Gomez.
And I'm Claudia Robles. Have a great weekend.